She wasn't.
No? Okay, so who are you voting for?
Hillary.
Why?
Well, I just think she'll make a great leader. She is a great leader. Truthfully, I'm a person of faith, and it's bothered me that so many folks that are folks of faith have been voting or Trump supporters for quite narrow reasons. So
you don't think Trump is a real Christian?
Well, I can't speak for his personal faith, but I don't think that he embodies the character that I would want to see emulated.
So, your husband?
Yeah.
So have you been trying to convince him to vote for him?
I know better.
Yes,
after 30.
Wait, hang on. Yes, she has.
After 35 years, I know I can't convince him, so.
So, what has been the talk like at the dinner table?
Oh, she's got very strong views about Hillary, and every morning we wake up and she tells me the latest news stories, some from CNN and some from other parts of the world, and it's been great dialogue. For me,
what kind of stories does she tell you?
Well, she usually wakes up with the latest sort of, this is the, if you will, the headline. And a lot of the headlines that she shares are the things that Trump has done. And there's been
the things that Trump has said about women.
Yeah, said about women. And that bothers me. I've raised two daughters, two beautiful daughters, that when you say certain things like a nasty woman, you just don't communicate that way. So that part of his personality and way of communicating has always bothered me.
Okay, so you've now made up your mind.
My deal breaker was the other night, Wednesday, during the debate. He basically said, I'm going to sabotage the democratic process in this country by not adhering to the way that people vote. And when I heard that, I said, while there are a lot of conservative values that are really important to me, you basically said something that for me is a deal breaker. We don't disrupt the democratic process in our country, and so I won't be voting for Trump. And it looks like I'll vote for Clinton because, the option is she at least presents the possibility for me to dialogue. And even though we can put different ideas on the table and say, you know, what this looks like, whether you're conservative or maybe more liberal, it doesn't matter. At the end of the day, I think there's a greater chance for us to work and process collectively with her than it would be with him. So
you are feeling what this morning, hearing your husband saying this?
Thank goodness.
Your marriage will stay intact.
Well, 35 years so far, we're going for 35 more. So,
awesome. Yeah. Thank you both for talking with me. I do appreciate it. Coming up next, I travel to Stark County. That's actually where I was born, in Canton, Ohio, where steel was once king. Will it ever come back? I'm skeptical. We'll talk about that next.